All right, good afternoon, Facebook Live. Today, we're talking about a very special topic. And the topic is how to not be an agent that is sucky to work with on the other side of a transaction. Fuck, man, I'm telling you, it is just getting so shitty out there with the egos and the, like, we're going to sue you in the lawsuits and the tone of the emails and the passive aggressiveness. So, guys, we're going to talk about three easy things you guys can do that everyone can do to not be that agent that sucks to work with on the other side of a transaction. Number one, don't ever project your numbers as the reason why the other agent should listen to you. This happens all the fucking time. I've got 23 years in the business. I closed 200 transactions last year, and I've never worked with anyone as unprofessional. Okay, first of all, I don't care if you do one transaction or 200 transactions. The agent on the other side doesn't give a fuck. Okay, nobody cares how many deals you closed last year when this transaction that you guys are in the middle of is the only focus. Nobody cares what you did. I had an agent last month tell me, oh, well, I only deal with million-dollar homes in Lake Tahoe. I'm like, well, if that's true, I don't give a shit. And number two, why are you having so much trouble closing this deal for $350,000 out here in Reno? So, guys, nobody cares about your numbers, and it is never, ever a reason why someone is going to listen to you. And as soon as you start projecting your numbers and your stats to somebody else, you're losing the conversation, and you're losing the rapport with the other person almost instantly. So, hey, what can you do instead of projecting your numbers that nobody cares about? You can come out and say something like, hey, you know what? I've been in this situation a few times before. Here's three solutions that we used in order to come up with, you know, possibly getting through this inspection or getting this repair done, or maybe we can reduce the price. We can give the buyer credit. We can do whatever. All right. Come up with solutions, not your numbers as to why somebody's going to be bullied into listening to what you have to say. Nobody gives a shit. Number two, just because your clients give you a green light to basically roast the other agent doesn't mean you should ever. I mean, like, look, at a certain time, deals go sour. They just do. And what typically happens is one side or the other, either the buyer or seller, always feels like they're getting fucked. Someone is going to start to feel like they're getting the bad end of the deal. And a lot of times it's the agent behind the deal, either the buyer's agent working with the buyers, you know, starting to chirp in their ear that the other agent isn't doing their job, they're not being responsive, or for a multitude of other reasons. You can tell this is happening when the agent goes from somewhat workable to writing these nasty little fucking emails to you and talking, you know, saying all this harsh language about contracts and sticking to, you know, the contract and liabilities, and this is going to end up in court and all this shit. Okay, look, man, just because your clients are pissed off at the other agent doesn't mean you should be. In fact, it's the opposite. When things start to go bad, that other agent needs to become your best friend. Why? Because they are the key to getting the deal done. You make that other agent your enemy, you can almost guarantee it's going to continue to go sideways, if not completely fall out of escrow altogether, because egos get in the way, and egos kill more deals coming together than they will ever bring them together. As soon as your ego gets in the way, you're fucked. I mean, as soon as you start getting into that mode where I'm the better agent and, you know, you stop wanting to work together with the other person, the deal's going to go bad. Number three, be calibrated. All right. Be a calibrated agent. When you're writing your emails, watch the tone of what you write. When something is going wrong in a deal, okay, just because suing the other person is an option doesn't mean you need to throw that out as the first thing you're going to write in the email. Or if this doesn't go the way that we have expected it to go, this is going to end up in court and my lawyer is going to get involved. Okay, that doesn't present a solution. So here's something that happened to me the other week. I had my seller legitimately and wrongfully took a generator out of the house and gave it to somebody as a gift before closing. Seller was wrong. My client was wrong 100%. I get this fucked up email from another agent talking about lawsuits and going to small claims courts. And if we don't do this and have a response by 4 p.m. in this email, that they're going to take further action. Okay. No phone call, no text message, just a bunch of bullshit email. Now, I call the seller, say, hey, Mr. Seller, this generator is part of the contract. Oh, yeah, you know what? I didn't know that. I'm sorry. I'll have it returned. Generator gets returned. Nothing happens. Okay. Crisis averted. I mean, it's like, guys, be calibrated in what you're doing. Do not be the asshole that projects your numbers. Okay. Just because your clients are pissed off doesn't mean you need to be pissed off at the other agent. It's actually the opposite. And just be socially calibrated in how you talk to people. If you think that putting out that energy into the world that you're going to sue somebody or you're going to get a lawsuit going because of this problem is like your first solution, you should probably just get out of the business, because the other agent is not your enemy. The agent is actually got to be your best friend, even if they're in the wrong, even if they're fucking up, even if they are the enemy, you better treat them like they're your friend. I can say this, I've had so many deals crash and burn where they're just miserable. And I come out of the deal like it sucked and the deal didn't get done and it was probably cost everybody money. But the agent on the other side, we end up coming out laughing about the whole thing, saying, man, that one really sucked. Hopefully we get one closed next time together. You can have a shitty deal. You can have it go sideways and still be on good terms with the other person across from you. It doesn't have to be combat. This doesn't have to be a war. And if you want to get more deals closed, make sure that that other agent is going to be on your good side. So if you guys have any questions about that, because agents, man, their egos are like, boom, just exploded through the fucking roof, especially the ones that don't do a lot of deals for some reason. They're the ones who are always, you know, really trying to play these power moves and over negotiate every single point. You guys have any questions, write them in the Facebook, the comment section. I'm sure everybody has like 10 billion stories about agents doing stupid shit. And we could probably talk about this for hours because it's actually really entertaining. All right. You guys have a good day. We'll see you tomorrow.